Towson Headlines Tuesday segment of 12 Teams in 12 Days. Bobby Broyles here in studio with Tim McDonald. A rough start to the season for the Tigers a year ago, but a quick three-game winning streak to end 2016 could propel this team as it enters a new campaign.
Up and down, and sometimes crazy year for Towson in 2016. He opened with a 1-7 record through the first 2 months. That brutal stretch, I mean, let's not forget, Nova and Richmond on the road in back-to-back weeks. Then it rolled over, I think, and it affected the rest of the schedule to harder defeats against Stony Brook, against Dartmouth, and against New Hampshire. That saw the Tigers have chances to steal a win. They were in those games, and it couldn't get the job done. Offense ranked fifth in total in the CAA, excuse me, with 368 yards per game. But constant injuries to some key guys kept changing how things moved, how the offense flowed, how things dictated up front. Ellis Knudsen, we saw him play quarterback, and Shane Simpson all of a sudden are called upon, two guys who we didn't talk about much or expect, but they came in called upon to take over the heavy loads. And Simpson was a bright surprise, 784 rush yards, 915 kick return yards, and a 26.9 kick per return average. So just goes to show how dangerous he can be. Lots of expectations heading into 2017 from Morgan Mihalik at quarterback, and still a guy who we don't know a lot. We haven't seen on tape a lot, and we haven't fully seen in action over the course of multiple games in a season. Missed six contests last year and comes back and helps finish Towson with three straight wins, 890 yards and four touchdowns in limited time again in 2016. So we still don't really know from a full standpoint. We don't know what to expect from Mihalik. All indications right now point to him being the starter. Knudsen, he's moved over to tight end, and leading receiver is also back in Sam Gallahan, but he only had 22 catches. Not to say that that's a major concern, but it is something to keep an eye on too for those offensive weapons. But in terms of depth on this side of the ball, it's not something we're accustomed to seeing for Towson when you think of a Towson offense. Turning last year over and starting fresh is critical. You think about the mistakes or turnovers and all the miscues that hurt this team in close games last year, whether it was a fumble, whether it was a pick. In my mind, though, that relates to the belief and confidence that a team has on offense, not something that always goes hand in hand or follows a team year after year. So I think that's something to keep in mind too. How much confidence does this offense have knowing that it has a fresh start?
We caught up with Towson head coach Rob Ambrose about his quarterback Morgan Mihalik at Media Day. Take a listen.
That's great that he's finally in the program for a full year. The understanding of what we're trying to do offensively. He did a little fly by the seat of your pants at the beginning of the season. At the end, he was really settling into himself in a groove. And the offseason's been a great, great work ethic that has shown for both he and the players that they've gravitated to. So I don't want to put too much pressure on him, but let's be honest. He's a quarterback. He's a head coach. Too much credit, too much criticism. High expectations.
Defensively, Tim, this team returns 10 starters from a very young unit a year ago. That has to be a huge positive before starting a new season.
I think that's the biggest positive you take. That how many times in this previous series have we talked about teams who want to flip the page, turn the corner, but they bring back so many guys, especially on defense.
Yep.
The same, if not the very similar mantra, landed on the defensive side a year ago. Just like the offense, just about everyone is back, and you gave up 27 points per game, which was 10th in CAA football, and a lot better versus the pass than against the run, allowing 170 yards per game, which was third in the league. A coordinator change also took place in the offseason in Lyndon Johnson. He comes over from Connecticut. Obviously, it has those ties with Rob Ambrose. He coached previously at Connecticut with Coach Ambrose and now is the leader of that defense. Monty Fenner, Chris Tedder, DeAndre Wallace were all sophomores a year ago. All those guys are back. All those guys played a lot, and all played 11 games, in fact, and they were asked to play a lot of football for this defense in trying times.
Yep.
And looking forward to watching how this defense handles playing in close games. I know we've hinted to it already, but look back to shootouts. You look back to the Richmond game. You look back to the Nova game, the William Mary, even the St. Francis game. And the St. Francis game was also crazy, back and forth early. With a young team, I don't think you always know what to expect from players. How do you react to giving up big plays? How do you react to making a mistake in a critical situation? Now the expectations have changed a little bit, and it's just under a year later. So what's that response going to take, or how's that going to look like on defense? That's what I want to see right away from Towson in 2017.
Once again, here is Coach Ambrose previewing his defense heading into 2017.
Well, I think that the group coming back has understood that they have a great responsibility. They really do. That if we're going to go where we want to go, that our good needs to get better, and our great needs to be awesome. And I think that they've really had an offseason where they're going to carry the mantle in that. Keon Pay's had a tremendous offseason. Lyris Klug's finally healthy for the first time. DeAndre Wallace and Chris Tedder always look really scary when they line up at linebacker. And up front, Zane Upshur, he's really had a great offseason. So I feel good about them. But there's depth behind those guys that we've just not had in the last 3 years, and that's probably why we've been where we are. We've been healthy. and that group's excited to come to practice.
Coach Ambrose and the Tigers look are a bit of a mystery team heading into 2017 with interesting pieces returning on both sides of the ball. Can you solve what the Tigers need to do to be successful this fall?
I think I can solve it. I don't think it's an easy answer. I don't think it's right off the bat, but last year's schedule was one of those strange schedules for me. That's where I start and think back, how did Towson get to this point and what can they do? That's one of those strange ones that it set up and it turned out like it did on paper. A difficult and grinding schedule, and that's plain and simple how Towson reacted. The effect of dropping one game soon flipped over to dropping a few games and dropping even more games. Not necessarily all on the Tigers, but part of the schedule, but I think it also carried over to the rest of the season. The schedule this year, let's flip the page, at least for me, is a good focal point on accepting the challenges right away and right in front of you. Three of the first four are on the road. After Morgan State at home, that's the opener. It's at Maryland, at St. Francis, and at Stony Brook. So right out of the gate, no time to rest and no time to take a break. Even in the majority of that non-conference play, I think it's going to be a challenge, but it's great to start on the road and face those challenges early. We will learn again the difference in Towson with three straight from the end of September and on. Nova and Richmond again in back-to-back fashion. That's at home, followed by a trip to Durham to take on New Hampshire. That three-game stretch is also really going to tell us. Battle-tested early could be a good thing for this team, searching to prove its potential. If we see the same Shane Simpson, a guy who by the end of the year no one wanted to kick to Shane Simpson.
No.
A guy who's dangerous at all times, you have to account for him on the field. And especially being the go-to guy in the backfield now, along with the progression and maybe some comfort from Morgan Mihalik, I think those questions on offense will take care of themselves for the better moving forward.
The Tigers open their season in Johnny United Stadium versus Morgan State on Saturday, September the 2nd at 6 p.m.
And CAFootball.com and our social platforms, that's Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram for all you new kids out there. Just search CAA Football. Has plenty of info on the Tigers, plus a feature sit-down right now with defensive back Monty Fenner, so be sure to head over to those platforms.
Two teams to go now, as Tim and I will be back Wednesday to break down Villanova. Have a great day, everyone.